While riding through the desert following the defeat of the Krayt Dragon in the season premiere, Mando is suddenly ambushed by a group of bounty hunters, who crash his speeder with a booby trap and attempt to take the child with them. After suffering some shots to his armor and fighting off the others, one of the three holds a knife to the child's throat, leading Mando trades his jetpack for the child's safety, only instead he remote controls it at the hunter runs away that incapacitates him. With the enemies defeated and no mode of transportation left to carry all of his supplies, Mando takes to walking through the desert, eventually arriving back in town at night. Mando enters the Mos Eisley Cantina to meet up with Pelly Motto, who is playing sabacc with a Dr. Mandible, who she claims can help him in his journey, and is sending a contact to meet with Mando at the hangar to lead him to other Mandalorians. Back at the hangar, Pelly and her droid workers are cooking up some of the Krayt Dragon meat using an old pod engine, and she discusses that a covert Mandalorian is somewhere in the nearby planet sector, though is unsure if they're the ones who left Navarro after the events of the first season. Though the contact wants no money for leading Mando to the Mandalorians, their request in exchange for the information is to travel with Mando to the system without using the hyperdrive, to which Mando is vehemently against. The contact turns out to be a frog lady, who is looking to transport her eggs, so they may be fertilized by the Equinox to keep her family line alive, and if Mando uses the hyperdrive, it will kill the eggs. They will be traveling to meet her husband on an estuary moon named Trask in the gas giant system of Kol Iban. From just before leaving Pelly's hangar to shortly after taking off, the child seems incredibly curious about the frog lady's tank of eggs, using the force to draw them close to it while observing the tank. As Mando heads downstairs into the rack of the ship to get some rest while it autopilots to the planet, we discover the child's true curiosity with the eggs lie in its hunger as it has opened the lid and is grabbing an egg to eat. Unfortunately, Mando isn't quick enough to stop it from eating one, but grabs it and seals the tank shut before it can eat any more. Mando is awoken in the midst of his sleep as a proximity alarm is sounding throughout the ship and returns to the cockpit in time as two X-Wings pull up alongside him, with pilots Captain Carson Teva and Trapper Wolf, questioning why his transponder isn't emitting. Trying to use the excuse that he is a pre-Empire surplus ship and therefore is exempt from this necessity, one of the pilots states the sector he's in is under New Republic jurisdiction, and that all craft must use their beacon. Before they leave, they request he send them a radar ping so as to ensure he's not an Imperial holdout, and after failing to convince them the system's not working, they demand he follow them to the outpost at Adelphi. After sending out a ping that awakens the frog lady, which the two pilots hear in the background, the X-Wings suddenly branch out their wings in combat form as they question whether he was recently in the vicinity of Bothan 5, but rather than answering their questions, Mando chooses to flee into the atmosphere of the nearest planet. Soaring through the clouds, Mando loses them just long enough that he kills his engine to fall towards the surface undetected, though the pilots still find him and chase him into a nearby icy canyon. Mando flies into a cavern in the middle of the ice canyon and half-parks, half-crashes into a secluded area long enough for them to evade detection, though the weight of the ship brings them crashing through the ice and into a subterranean level. Waking sometime later after the wreck, Mando wakes the unconscious frog lady, and heads downstairs to find her some blankets to keep warm as well as her eggs, but discovers a large hole in his ship letting in the snow and the seeming disappearance of both the eggs and the child. While looking around his ship, however, he finds the child hidden under a tarp once again trying to eat the eggs, eating at least one while asking it how many others he ate. With the ship badly damaged and night approaching, he's unsure about their prospects and the frog lady tries desperately to get his attention regarding the sensors on her egg tank, though due to the language gap he's unable to understand what she's saying. As Mando falls asleep with the child cuddling up to him, the frog lady notices the remains of droid Q9-0, Richard Ioade, Sol, and finds a way to use the system's vocabulator to translate what she has to say to him, telling him the eggs are the last of her life cycle, and her husband has found the only planet hospitable to their species, and they've fought too hard and suffered too much to see the extinction of her family line. She tries to appeal to his dedication to the Mandalorian code in honoring an agreement, driving him to find a new way to help them escape. While working on repairs for the ship, the child visits Mando and tries to get his attention towards something, though Mando simply scolds it and asks it tries to help if it's going to be out there. Disappointed, the child walks away, leading Mando to follow him, where he realizes the child was trying to point out that the frog lady has left, requiring Mando to follow after her into the nearby icy caverns. Using the thermal camera in his helmet, Mando is able to track the frog lady to a nearby cavern that has a hot spring, where she's warming herself and the eggs. Quickly gathering the eggs up before night arrives, Mando stops the child from eating any more, to which it ventures off as it notices egg-shaped formations nearby and opens one of them up to find an unborn spider-like creature, Krikna, that it subsequently eats. This, however, is interrupted as the rest of the nearby eggs begin to hatch, leaving the group surrounded by the little creatures and forced to flee from one massive creature, as well as hundreds of medium-sized ones. While running through the caves and shooting scores of the smaller ones, Mando turns and used three thermal grenade-like devices to bring down one of the large ones. Using the flamethrower of his suit, Mando and the group narrowly escape being surrounded and make it back to the Razor Crest, where he tries to seal them off in the cockpit. As a few break through and try to attack the child, the frog lady uses a smaller blaster to rescue it, and Mando uses his flamethrower again to kill a large enough portion that he can close and lock the door. In a last-ditch effort to escape the creatures, Mando attempts to take off, but is stopped as another large creature lands on top of the ship and pierces through the windshield with its legs. As it attempts to break through with its mouth, the creature is suddenly gunned down by an unknown presence, which is revealed to be the two X-Wing pilots from their ships who have found Mando. Running the ship's history through their system and finding he has an arrest warrant for the abduction of a prisoner, but since he also helped turn over three wanted criminals and put his life on the line to save Lieutenant Davin of the New Republic Correctional Corps, they agree to have him forego the bounties of the three in exchange for his freedom, leaving Mando to have to fix both his transponder and his ship. Without help from the X-Wing pilots, Mando elects to attempt to fly to Trask with the main hull still having a hole in it, so he fixes up the cockpit to keep them safe during the trip, where they must all stay. As Mando and the frog lady fall asleep with the ship heading slowly to their destination, we see the child at some point has snagged one final egg to eat.